We must revive Lysinar. King Fandom said, clearly relieved. Well, how? Bren asked. Have you ever heard of the lost city of Lavia? Well, myth claims that when the city was destroyed, it wasn't just destroyed, it was simply banished, alongside all things in the world that may ever threaten the integrity of Minecraftia. Clearly this wouldn't work, as Minecraftia would fall anyway. But what I care about, Fandom continued, is a supposed text that can revive the dead. This may be our key. And where will we find this key exactly? Well, after a few hours of discussion, Fandom would leave to discuss with his Prime Minister, Teklava, about governing the Oskani while he would be gone. Bren watched as an unusually large gust of wind swept across the mountainside of New Oskanian. He looked on at the flowers fighting for their life inside of a dirt mound, and two guards joined Bren on the window. "Place my bets on the Camus," the first guard said. "I like the dandelion," the second guard said, as if it was made to make them shut up. And what did he know about flowers? He had not been raised among them like Bren had. He did not have them along his windows. He did not play in those old, hilly flower fields like Bren did. Bren took a quick glance, then boldly stated, "Going with the tulip." The guards just shook their head. The tulip appeared to be ready to be torn apart by the wind, so far away, more successful the wind than the others. "Heard about the riots?" the first guard asked. "In Vetkrona?" "One's about the supply shortages," the second one responded. "Yeah, the citizens can't afford any food or armor, because all getting diverted away to the military after the war." "It's sad, really," Bren added on. The conversation quickly turned into a mocking of Chancellor Pug of Boralia, making fun of his poor governance, discovered they munched in common with each other. "I'm sure Black will have an easy time defeating that mess of a state. Those generals are so stupid, man." First guard joked. "Generals are good men," second guard said as a fact once more. "Let it go," another gust coming. As the wind hit the flowers, the three anticipated their flower's victory. Unexpectedly, the canvas began to fall apart first, its petals flying into the wind. "Stupid flower," muttered the first guard. Now it's between the dandelion and the tulip. It's funny surprising the tulip had held on for so long. But the wind's direction had changed, the second guard let out a yell, echoing throughout the fort as the dandelion fell apart too. Bren's tulip was victorious. How did you know that the tulip would win? "I don't know. Just had a feeling," Bren shrugged. Back in Vetkrona, chaos had overtaken the city for a variety of reasons. First of all, Pug had filled the Senate with his generals and political allies, allowing them to pass whatever laws he wished. The only person with any major political power besides him was the king, who was very uninterested in political matters. Thus, democracy had been killed in Vetkrona. Secondly, the war effort and the poor planning had led to a food shortage among the casual civilian population, and much of it had to be funneled away for the war. Large protests began in the city, and the war became increasingly unpopular. Blackwood had undertaken an interesting strategy of guerrilla warfare, becoming masters at tricking the Boralian soldiers. Hiding in the trees and caves of the mountain, along major pathways, they were able to sabotage, capture, otherwise psychologically torture these soldiers. Their goal was not to win the war, as Boralian had a far more sophisticated infrastructure. They just simply wanted to drag it out, forcing a white peace. People such as Mr. Phoneby prepared great defenses inside the borders of Blackwood, its capital itself, preventing any assaults directly into it. At this rate, Boralia was sure to collapse under its own weight. Pug would take an esoteric solution to this. While on a walk in the city, he came to the conclusion that only he can save Boralia. After all, he won that election for something. and he was going to take full advantage of it. A cult personality would emerge as Puck prepared to put himself at the center of the national image. As Chancellor, he was the law now, right? And for a state and fair law, they couldn't have anyone disrupting the process, could they? His yes-man generals only nodded. And as Puck went to bed that night, he could only hear the screaming of civilians outside.
You know, I don't think we've ever really talking too much about, you know, how did you, like, become king?
I actually ruled this place even before the founding of US Canyon, along with Prime Minister Declava. But, it's not actually that common in comparison to other people being crowned king.
Bren and Funtime began their adventure to find the lost city of Lavia, praying those learn himself that they would not run out of food. It was a difficult journey, long after spent in brutal storms and harsh weather, transforming the many threats of the forest that would not hesitate to rip the two to threads. It's very, I don't know what we're gonna do. I mean, hopefully.
Wait.
Is that?
Is that the location?
Wow, that's.
That's surprisingly big.
I mean, I didn't. See if we can get in.
Got in. And that's definitely the flag that they described.
Wow. That's...
That's surprising.
In the lost city of Lavia, they'd find, at the very top, only ruins. The only exception being the ancient flag of clear and great importance. Its meaning now greatly lost to time.
Wow.
Just the ruins?
Very unreal to be. Wait. But what's in here? Huh? Bren, what's this place?
What is this place?
This place is weird. What's all of this?
Is there a book? Is that the...
Man, this book has some Minecraftian inscriptions. Thank God I learned Minecraftian as my first language.
Really? Okay, try to read it for us.
I'm gonna try to, I think if I dropped... I think I have this... If I dropped it here... Will it make some effect?
Let's try.
Let me try to read this again in some effect. Lisenarischen, Kaiserleitin der Minecraftien, Schiborne Garbonk Menker Zarvornen, Carvon Mungarazzi, Schwernen Parfuten, Avuss Kaiserleitos, Munhener Lernen, Avuss Kaiser Leeches, Av Menen Livori Magarun, Avuss, 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 Avuss. See, I told this was. Wait.
What?
What's going on?
Who's that?
Bren, I'm scared.
Why? What's going on?
Where's the exit?
This is.
Bren, I'm scared.
I'm scared.
Ich bin zurück. Ich bin endlich zurück.
Praise to him, the font of all our wisdom. Long to live, the ruler of our barn, Napoleon, mighty leader. Mighty leader, watching over us. Napoleon, mighty leader. Mighty leader, watching over us. Bend on the high, you guide us with your smile.